por fin sentirme en casa. Yo, so did you study something? Did you study anything?
Yeah, I studied myself.
Okay, what pages or what resources are you using to study?
Normally I use a YouTube channel. There are two guys I like the most.
Which one? What's the channel's name?
Español con Juan.
Español con Juan. Okay, and what's the other one?
Spanish dude.
Spanish dude.
Sí.
Okay. I would highly appreciate if you share with me those links when we're done with the lesson. So to get started, I wanted to introduce with Sebastian and in Spanish, of course, and saying why you are learning Spanish. Ciao.
Okay. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
So go ahead. Yeah.
Introduce myself.
Yeah. Okay, I want you to say why you're learning Spanish in Spanish.
Okay. Hola, soy Yaoyun. Soy una china. Estoy aquí en Panamá. Entonces he aprendido español por casi 10 meses y trabajando con una organización aquí de Naciones Unidas. Entonces, Naciones Unidas, Unidas, sí. Entonces, necesito trabajando en español, y aprendido mucho ahora, sí.
¿Te ha parecido fácil el español?
¿Qué? ¿Qué? Lo siento, ¿qué?
¿Te ha parecido fácil?
Para mí no es fácil, pero he aprendido inglés antes de español, entonces es un poco mejor. Inglés es fácil, pero español no. Los conjugaciones, cambios, verbos, no me parece es fácil.
Okay, so Sebas, in English,
I'm learning English in this moment.
why?
For me, it's very difficult learning English.
Pero
Spanish
es
is very easy, but English, no.
pero no tiene los conjugaciones, los cambios, verbos, en inglés. Creo que como español, como una persona habla español, es fácil para ti, ¿no?
Yes.
Sebas, cuéntale a ella por qué estás aprendiendo inglés en inglés, porfa.
Okay. Ciao. I'm learning English because I'm working in a company, in a French company named Ipsos. Ipsos. Ipsos is yes, Ipsos is seen in around the world in 96 countries. China is a one country is a one country in the under Ipsos in no I I P S O S Ipsos.
Ah, sí.
Sí.
Okay.
So I have speaking English with different people around the world. So I must learn very very fast because my role in this company is a is a is 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 a very, very important in it's a very important relation. It's a very important relationship with people of other from other countries, from other countries. Yes.
Yes. Okay. Yo también.
You understand me something?
Yes. Yeah. Everything. I understand everything.
Yeah, so you already know how this works, so we'll continue working on the guide that we have been working lately. So basically the only difference is that Yao is going to be doing the Spanish part and Sebastian is going to be doing the English part, and I will be helping you on the go. And the idea is that you also ask each other questions, random questions about whatever you want, so you get to practice with one another and with a different accent than mine, because I know that it can be a bad thing to get used to just one accent. So the idea is that you get a chance to listen to someone else's accent in order for you to be able or more able to understand another person speaking in the language that you're learning. Okay.
Ciao. If you want to practice Spanish, you can call me when you Ander, cuando tú quieras.
When you want.
Sí, sí, sí.
When you want. Claro. Yeah.
So I want you to remember what the name of my brand is. My brand's name is Spanglish. So if you don't know how to say something, the good thing about this level in which you're at right now, both of you, is that you can do Spanish, both of you, Spanglish, and you will both understand one another because you've already both know a lot of language. So you will be able to communicate with one another, even if it's not only on one language. So that's a very good idea that you arrange some meetings if you can, because that will help you improve your speaking skills.
Yeah, sure. And okay. Sebas, if you want to practice English, of course, like we can chat in a mix of English and Spanish.
Yes. Thank you, Xiao.
So one thing to get started, Sebas, her name is Yao. Yao.
Yao.
Yao.
Yao. Okay.
Yao.
Yao Yun, right? Yao Yun.
Yeah. Yao Yun, yeah. But Yao is fine. Yao is good.
Okay, yeah. Okay, so let's get started then. So we were here. I left off here with Sebastian, but it's pretty much where you both are at right now. So Sebastian, pronunciation, the man who phoned didn't give his name.
I don't understand you, Ander.
The pronunciation of the example.
This I can see the screen. Ah, yeah.
Okay, there you go.
The man who phoned didn't give his name.
Okay, yeah, what's that in Spanish?
El hombre llamada no dar su nombre.
El hombre, so Sebastian, how would you translate this one?
El hombre.
Mm-hmm. El hombre.
El hombre, ¿quién llama?
¿Quién llama?
¿Qué llamó?
¿Qué llamó? No dio su nombre.
Yes.
No dio su nombre.
So yes. Whenever we're connecting ideas with who, which, or that in English, Yao, you should use the word que. So in that case, el hombre, que, which would be who, llamó, no dio su nombre. So once again, pronunciation. El hombre que llamó no dio su nombre.
El hombre que llamó no dio su nombre.
Nice. So the next one, Sebastian. So you need to fill in the gap and go ahead. What do you think it's a correct way to fill it?
The woman,
mm-hmm.
the woman who opened the door.
Mm-hmm.
They opened the door, was wearing a yellow dress.
Otra vez, Sebas. The woman who opened the door.
The woman who opened the door was wearing a yellow dress.
Wearing a yellow dress.
Was wearing a yellow dress.
Good. How do you translate this?
La mujer abrió
la mujer.
Abrió la puerta. Estaba llevando un vestido a yellow,
amarillo.
Amarillo.
So yeah, I want you to repeat after me. So la mujer que abrió la puerta.
La mujer que abrió la puerta.
Estaba usando un vestido. Un vestido amarillo, sorry.
Vestido amarillo.
Yeah, Sebas, the next one. How do you feel up the next guest?
Most of the students who took the exam, most of them passed.
Okay, Sebastian, repeat after me. Most of the students who took the exam didn't pass. Passed. Passed.
Only
passed. Sí, o sea, no se diría otra vez la mayoría de listo.
I recommend you that you write the complete sentence, but because Yao can read it more easy.
Okay. So, Yao, how would you say that one? Most of the students... La mayoría de estudiantes... Who took the exam...
Que lleva la examen.
Que tomaron el examen.
Que tomaron el examen.
Passed.
Pasaron.
I would say lo pasaron.
Pasaron.
As in passed it.
Sí.
Okay.
La mayoría.
Okay. Sebas, ¿cómo dirías en inglés? ¿Qué prefieres hacer? ¿Llamar a tus amigos o hablar con ellos por texto?
Llamar a mis amigos.
¿Pero cómo lo dirías en inglés?
¿La pregunta? What do you prefer? Call you your friends or his or her friends or chat? No, I don't know chat. Chat
or texting with them.
Or texting with them.
Yao, how would you respond to this question in Spanish?
Prefiero llamar mis amigos. Porque a lo mejor se puede verlos.
Porque puedo verlos. Yao, ¿y qué pasa si ellos están ocupados?
Normalmente cocino por un tiempo largo, como una hora o dos horas cada vez. Yo hizo ejercicio, hago ejercicios y hago yoga y meditaciones.
Okay, so what do you understand from this question? ¿Qué pasa si ellos están ocupados?
What do you do when you are not busy?
No, that means what if they're busy when you call them?
What if? ¿Qué pasa si ellos están ocupados?
Yeah.
Okay. I think my hearing of your accent is very like not like the Panamanian accent. I'm still getting used to it.
Yeah, well, I mean, like I've heard that Panamanian accent is sort of can be a bit too fast. I've heard that it can be even too fast for Spanish for native Spanish speakers.
Yeah, I think they are very fast. Ellos hablan muy muy rápido.
Okay.
Y si ellos están ocupados, no sé, pueden me dicen.
Ellos me dicen, okay, good. Let's go on then. Let's have a look at the next exercise. I had another question, but I forgot. Okay, no, you know what? Yeah, how would you say in Spanish, how do you describe your style?
Como un descriptil su estilo.
Once again, repeat after me, ¿cómo describes tu estilo?
¿Cómo describís tu
Estilo. Yeah,
estilo?
Sebas, how do
Yes.
you answer this question in English?
How do you describe your style?
Yeah, how would you answer that question?
What?
Yeah, ¿cómo la respondes? ¿Cómo la responderías en inglés?
I think so that I'm very, very friendly, and I like good quality life,
A high quality, I like having a good, a high quality life.
yes, I'm not. I'm not adventure person, adventure people, no sé.
¿Qué quieres decir? ¿Qué querías decir ahí?
No soy una persona pues como muy aventurera.
I'm not an adventurous
No,
person.
adventures.
What's the
Adventure.
spelling of this? Do you know it? Yeah, I don't, I'm not sure. Adventurous like this, right? Something like that. An adventurous person.
Truer.
Adventure here.
Oh.
Well, okay. You know what I mean, right?
Yeah.
Okay, an adventurous person.
I like workout all days, very early. I How do you say meditación?
I also like meditating.
I meditated with like to yao. I'm very I'm very I'm No, Anderson.
Hágale, hágale,
I think so that I like a dinner healthy comida or eat meal eat.
I
I
also
like
like
eat, I like
healthy
eat
food.
healthy Yeah, I also like healthy food. In this habit, I think so the oriental food is a good option in my menu
Okay.
in the day.
Okay. Are you considering?
I don't like cooked. I don't like cook.
Okay. I don't like cooking. I don't only like it, I fucking hate it. I hate cooking. That's like the worst thing that can happen to me, to be pushed to cook. Oh shit, I hate that.
Me encanta.
Okay. I know. You should come and introduce me some meals of yours.
Yeah, absolutely.
Do you plan to come to Colombia when, I mean, if we get to travel anytime soon?
Yeah, of course. I really want to travel.
Okay, how many countries do you want to go to after Panama?
In Latin America?
Well, I mean, overall.
For now, I really want to go to Argentina. Argentina, Uruguay, los países en el sur de América.
¿Por qué?
Porque hay una cultura muy, muy activa, muy uh-huh. interesante, y hay personas que me gusta desde allí, allí. No sé.
Okay, good. So, Yao, ¿cuál fue el último examen que tomaste en tu vida?
La última.
El último examen que tomaste.
El último examen. Ah, ayer yo tomé uh-huh. un examen desde línea.
¿De qué?
Desde línea es un examen sobre los comercio internacional y tarif okay. sobre okay. los ya yeah, eso es lo tome la lo último
sobre comercio internacional
about sí trade commerce, about international trade.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Comercio internacional. Yeah, that's okay. Sebastian, let's do this one, the fourth exercise. So, how do you do it?
The policeman who stopped our car wasn't very friendly.
Yeah. So, yeah. How do you say that?
La policía. Que palal nuestro cadro no es muy simpático.
Carro no era
no era
muy you could also say no era muy amigable.
No era muy amigable.
But simpático is also okay. I would not say it, but it sounds nice.
Uh-huh.
Okay. So, el policía que paró nuestro carro no era muy amigable. Sebas, ¿cómo dirías el policía que paró nuestro carro era un hijo de puta?
In Colombia, it's very common to use the word hijo de puta es una agresión, es una palabra agresiva.
Agresiva.
Sí, hijo de puta. It's the word. It's a word very dangerous in Colombia. It's not recommend. I don't recommend you use this word. Yes.
Pero cómo lo traduces? Pero cómo lo traduces, pues Sebas, a ver.
I say this expression is. Policía hijo de puta, así.
But how would you say it in English? How would you say that the policeman who stopped our car was hijo de puta?
A son of bitch?
You could say that, yeah. That's a very accurate translation. I would also use it for an asshole.
Yeah.
If you want to call someone an asshole or a son of a bitch, you just call him fucking hijo de puta.
Fucking hijo de puta. Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, if you say, well, but that's very rude. Like you can get punched in the face.
Ah.
So I'm teaching you language. How you use it, it's up to you.
No te preocupes.
Yeah, I mean, and you want to know when people are mistreating you, right?
Yeah, of course.
If they're saying, oh, this fucking Chinese is un hijo de puta.
Then I
you want
know.
To know. You want to know if they're mistreating you because they're going to have a problem with you.
Ander, how do you say admirar?
Admire.
I'm admire the discipline of Chinese and Japanese people.
You like the disciplinary style of life.
Yes.
But it's very funny.
They are very disciplined people. Yes.
But that's very funny because I've been talking to Anzi and she's like, oh no, Ander, I'm not your regular Chinese disciplined woman. So she's all the time like, did you study? Oh no, I got lazy. I didn't study.
yeah. Pero creo que lo que quiere decir de Sebas es los chinos y japonés es muy simpático, no es muy fácil tu ser enojado en las calles, ¿sí?
Well, no. What?
Like, we are not very easily to become angry.
En español, se dice, son muy educados y respetuosos de la norma.
Ah, son muy educados.
Sí. Educados, that's like you are very polite, like you're very polite.
Sí.
Very polite.
Very polite.
Yes, muy.
Do you think that's an accurate statement for your culture?
I think so. Creo que sí. Because Chinese and Japanese, those East Asian people, we are more calm.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. In Spanish, this.
Es muy calma, no sé.
Somos muy calmados.
Calmados, somos muy calmados. Sí.
What do you think about the people, Colombian people or Latino American people?
Creo que
in
la
Spanish,
gente,
Spanish.
Yeah, la gente aquí en la región América Latina y el Caribe encuentro que la gente es muy disfrutar la vida y relajarse y no preocupe de nada, no sé. Yo preocupo mucho sobre mi vida, sobre los dineros, ingresos, pero aquí ellos están disfrutando su vida, disfrutando, sí, creo que es lo muy importante diferencia.
Okay. I think so about this that the Latin American people have many problems. How many problems to resolve? Because we have many how do you say preocupaciones in English?
A lot of worries.
A lot of worries. So I did learn to live with this.
¿Qué dijiste al final?
Nosotros ya aprendimos a vivir con eso. How to live with that, yes.
En serio, creo que el problema como corrupción,
Yes.
coima.
Yes. Va, narcotraffic. Narcotraffic, how do you say violencia under?
Violence.
Violence, robs, etc., etc. Many, many under delitos.
Delitos, crimes.
Many have crimes, and so for we so we learn to take to we learn to relax in this situ in all situations.
Ah, ustedes ya
Yes.
adaptan a esta situación.
Yes. Exactly.
So I want one thing that I want to mention again. You will probably know this is that as you are speaking, I am correcting the things that you are saying on the text that I'm showing you on my screen. So I don't know if you have you been reading the notes that I've been writing down while you're speaking.
Sí, estoy describiendo la nota.
Okay, so yeah, so I don't want to interrupt your speech. So this is how I'm correcting you, so you don't stop your speaking, like your speech, while sharing an idea or an experience. So that's the idea, that you don't stop watching the screen while you are talking. So you are kind of having a look at the corrections without having to actually stop your speech. Okay.
Okay, claro.
Okay, so let's have a look at the next exercise. And remember, if you've got any question, I highly recommend you that, or encourage you to try to make up new questions to ask one another, so you can both talk, and so you don't stop talking. And any questions that you may have on the go to ask me, as you have been doing it today. So let's do who or which. So this is more of an exercise for Sebas, because in Spanish it's just que, either one.
Yeah.
But let's see how you both do in this one. So Sebastian, pronunciation of the example. The first one, I met a woman who can speak six languages.
Pronunciation, entonces, I meet a woman who can speak six languages.
Met a woman.
Met a woman.
How about you, Yao? How would you translate this?
Met. Vi una mujer que puede hablar seis idiomas.
Once again,
Conocí.
conocí. Yes, I met, conocí.
Ah, conocí a una mujer que puede hablar seis idiomas.
Yes, another thing to keep in mind for you is that another one of the other translations that meets God is encontrarse con. Sebas, ¿cómo dirías? ¿Nos vamos a encontrar mañana o no?
In Spanish, we have many problems with the idiom because we don't how do you say seguir under? Seguir las reglas gramaticales.
We don't follow the rules.
We don't follow the rule the grammar rules. In Spanish, I say, hey, nos vemos mañana. It's an
See you
expression.
tomorrow.
It's an expression. Hey, nos vemos mañana.
Pero entonces, pero vamos a usar esta. ¿Cómo dirías esta, Sebas? ¿Nos encontramos mañana o no?
Nos podemos encontrar mañana o nos encontramos mañana.
¿Cómo lo dirías en inglés?
En inglés, can we meet? Can we meet tomorrow? Can we meet tomorrow?
Tomorrow. ¿Cómo dirías o no?
Can you?
Can't we?
Can't we? Eso, can't we?
Listo, entonces, did you understand it in Spanish? Podemos, encontrarnos would be meet, which is reflexive. So podemos encontrarnos mañana, which is tomorrow, and can't we would be o no.
Oh no.
Yes.
Can't.
Yes. Yeah. So let's do the pronunciation of that sentence. So podemos encontrarnos mañana o no.
Podemos encontrarnos mañana o no.
Yeah. And remember to add a question tone when you're actually asking a question. So podemos encontrarnos mañana o no.
Podemos encontrarnos mañana o no.
Exactly. Yeah. You should definitely keep that in mind so people don't get confused regarding if you're asking a question, if you're just saying a statement, okay?
Sí, claro.
So, Sebastian, the second one.
The second one. What's the name of the man who has just started work in your office?
Yes, anyhow.
¿Cuál es el nombre de este hombre que ya empecé a trabajar en esta oficina?
¿Cuál es el nombre del hombre? That's like very random, but. So yeah. Do you see this word, acabo de? Have you ever seen it? Do you recognize what it is?
Yeah. Just doing something.
Exactly, yeah. So what's the name of the guy who just started working at your office? So once again, read it.
¿Cuál es el nombre de hombre que acabo de empezar a trabajar en tu oficina?
Yes, the two first again, repeat after me, ¿cuál es?
¿Cuál es?
Yeah, good. Sebas, ¿cómo dices en inglés? ¿Cómo haces para recordar los nombres de las personas que acabaste de conocer?
How do you manage?
O sea, manage es como arreglárselas para hacer algo. Entonces, como, ¿cómo te las arreglas para recordar los nombres de las personas que acabaste de conocer?
Manage to remember.
Mm-hmm.
Remember the names.
Mm-hmm.
Names who of the people have just know. You just met.
How do you manage to remember the names of the people you just met? Otra vez, Sebas, pronunciation.
How do you manage to remember the names of the people you just met?
Como con a just. You just met. Listo. Yeah, how do you answer this question in Spanish?
Acabo de conocer. Tengo que escribir su nombre y tengo que preguntarlos otra vez.
¿Cuántas veces lo preguntas? ¿Cuántas veces lo vuelves a preguntar?
Normalmente 3 o 4, no sé.
What I usually do is that that only applies if you are in a group sort of setting. So what I do is that if I don't know the two other people that I just met, their names, so I asked this one the name of the other one, and then I go to the other one and ask the other person, and that way I don't make the awkward moment of asking them, like, hey, you know, like, I don't think you're important, so I forgot your name, kind of thing, feeling. So that's what I do in order not to ask them directly what their names are. So, but that only applies if it's like that, or if it's just one person, I would say, like, have you got any other name? Or what's your full name? Like, your full name, what is it?
pero el nombre de los españoles es muy largo, super.
Yeah, I know that we've got very long words in Spanish. I just realized that once I started teaching Spanish, like, I was like, shit, yeah, the average Spanish word is really long. compared to the ones in English, at least the ones in English. I wouldn't be able to compare them with Chinese words, but I don't know. Okay, so let's have a look at the next exercise. So, Sebastian, continue, the third one.
What's the name of the river which flows through the town?
Flows through the town?
Flows through the town?
Through the town?
Through the town?
Yes, and yeah, how do you translate this?
¿Cuál es el nombre del río que fluye de pueblo?
Que fluye. Let me show you. Que fluye a través del río, del pueblo, del pueblo.
A través de pueblo.
Pueblo.
Pueblo. El río que fluye a través de pueblo.
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 Yeah. Yao, ¿cuál es tu ciudad favorita de China?
Mi ciudad favorita de China. Creo que es Chengdu.
¿Por qué?
Porque en esta ciudad la gente vive muy muy lento, no es muy efectivo tomar café y comer breakfast. Oh my god, breakfast, how to say?
Y desayunar
muy lento. Es una ciudad muy lento y la gente relajarse, disfrutarse la vida.
Y la gente disfruta la vida.
Disfruta la vida.
Yao, what do the people Chinese think about the enjoy the life? What is the meaning enjoy the life in the Chinese people?
Para mí la mayoría de personas chinas tiene problema de disfrutar la vida porque los chinos faltan dinero por un tiempo muy largo.
What did you mean in that last part? I didn't understand what you meant.
Because Chinese people lack of money for a long time. Like for the last century, we don't have money, we don't have resources.
So you lack money for a very long time?
Yes, like for my parents, my grandparents, for a long time, for the generations before.
Okay, so you want to have like a lot of money, so that's why you don't enjoy life, or?
Yeah, because they are lack of money. Ellos faltan dinero.
Mm-hmm.
A ellos les falta dinero. Entonces, por su vida, no tengo una sensación seguro. Ellos quieren trabajar para hacer dinero.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So it's kind of like making sure that you will never run out of money in your life.
Sí, para mis padres y grandpadres, creo que sí. Para ahora está mejorando.
Okay, ahora está mejorando. But you know what? Like, I think that's the beauty of traveling, because you get to experience cultures like Latin American one, And then you realize that it's okay to enjoy your life while you're actually still making progress and reaching the goals that you've got for your life. And that includes financial goals, of course. So I think it's a mix of everything. Like, it's not about working all the time and not enjoying life, but at the same time, enjoying life all the time without actually thinking that a future is going to come. I mean, I think that's reckless. I think that not thinking about the future whatsoever is reckless. Like don't beat yourself up because of the possibilities in the future, but make a plan. Like definitely, you should definitely have a plan, because what if we do get to live 150 years? What if, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Like enjoy your life today, but hey, fucking make a plan.
Yeah.
That's kind of the mindset that I try to live my life in, so... But sometimes it's difficult, but that's what I try to do.
Yao, te voy a hablar en español, aunque yo pienso que en Colombia las personas que estamos de la clase media hacia arriba tenemos unas vidas muy agitadas también, y estamos en un ritmo de vida en el que queremos tener una muy buena calidad de vida, conseguir dinero, tener resueltos los temas relacionados con el estudio, la universidad, entre otros. Entonces, el ritmo de vida para esas personas es bastante agitado en Colombia también.
Ah, sí.
De pronto, las personas que no tienen la preocupación de conseguir y conseguir dinero, si tratan de disfrutarse más la vida.
Ah, es la razón que, porque así que persona está viviendo así.
Y de hecho, últimamente hay unos nuevos pensamientos, unas nuevas tendencias que están haciendo que las personas de clase media hacia arriba traten de disfrutar más la vida y de ver las cosas simples que hay en la vida y de estar menos en el ritmo del trabajo y el afán de conseguir y conseguir.
Sí, sí, claro.
Sebas,
¿qué entendió en inglés?
Did you understand what he said?
I understand. I mean, the person in Latin America, like Colombia, I also try to get money, making life, and also, but for the richer part of the society, they are more enjoying the life. They're not worried about the tendency here is getting rich. Is that what I'm understanding correctly?
Getting what?
Like. The tendency in
getting rich, but I mean, like, middle class and high class, if you will.
Yeah.
Middle class. Hey, pero Sebas, pues cómo vas a decir que vos sos clase media, huevón. Ya te las vas a dar de humilde, marica.
Ander, las personas de clase media son las que estamos en ingresos inferiores a los, mejor dicho, todavía los estratos 3, 4, no tenemos activos como empresas, patrimonios grandes, nada de eso, o sea, somos simplemente asalariados, si me hago entender,
sí.
Somos de clase media, por eso es que los impuestos nos los tragamos todos nosotros, bla, 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 bla.
Bueno, entonces, por definición, alguien de clase alta, ¿qué es? O sea,
unos ingresos pues brutales, estamos hablando de gente que recibe 60 millones de pesos, 40, 30.
Es decir, para no decir que es de clase alta, tiene que ser lo que uno dice millonario.
Exacto, tiene que ser que es...
O sea, uno debe tener 3,000 millones de pesos en el banco y no deber nada.
Algo así, gente que tiene mucho dinero.
Uy, eso sí, parce, es que no tener... 3,000 palos en la cuenta y no deber nada.
Pero ¿cómo se llama high class, middle class en Spanish? Clase alta.
Clase,
Clase alta, clase media. Y
Clase
clase.
media.
Yeah, now the thing is that here in Colombia there are some things that we call estratos.
Estratos socioeconómicos.
Like stress, estrato.
It's more like I don't know, like status. If I wouldn't know how to, it's like a status, like status one, status two, status three, status four, status five. Aquí hay estrato seis, yo no sé. En Colombia estrato seis.
Sí, ese es poblado, Laureles, son estrato 6. Estrato 1, estrato 4, estrato 3, estrato 2 y estrato 1. Y los de
Estratos,
estratos,
estratos.
sí, estratos socioeconómicos. Los estratos 1 y 2 son clase baja.
Ah,
Los
sí.
estratos 3, 4 y 5 se supone que son clase media, pero hay personas de clase media que están en estrato 6. ¿Sí?
Ya entiendo.
It's only in Colombia.
Pero el estrato es una definición de los gobiernos.
Yes.
¿En serio?